But we're going to start with the Fox News alert now. Nathan Wade stepping down from the Trump election case in Georgia after the judge rules that Fulton County DA Fani Willis must cut ties with her special prosecutor or quit the case herself.
In his exit letter, Wade says, quote, I am offering my resignation in the interests of democracy, in dedication to the American public, and to move this case forward as quickly as possible.
In the interest of democracy. Yeah. How amazing of
him.
He's
a patriot.
This comes after Willis was forced to take the stand over her relationship with Wade, which ended up overshadowing the Trump case and led to moments like this one.
You're confused. You think I'm on trial. These people are on trial for trying to steal an election in 2020. I'm not on trial, no matter how hard you try to put me on trial. Let me tell you which one you lied in. Right here. I think you lied right here. No. This is the truth,
Judge.
It is a lie.
So Fox News legal analyst Gregg Jarrett joins us now. Gregg, great to have you this morning. So from best I and we can tell, Judge McAfee attempted to sort of split the baby here, to do something that maybe wasn't politically controversial in Fulton County, but also punish Willis and Wade for the appearance of impropriety. What he said, and I wanted to ask you about, is he said, although it's clear their behavior was at best frowned upon, at worst much more, he said it didn't impact the defendant, in this case, Donald Trump and others, due process rights.
Yeah, well, he's wrong, Will. I mean, this decision, if you read it, 23 pages, it's illogical. It's self-contradictory. The judge found both Willis and Wade engaged in the same wrongful, improper conduct that under law and ethics demands removal. And yet he orders that only one of them has to leave the case? I mean, that makes no sense, obviously, because the appearance of impropriety remains, and it infects the case and the defendant and his due process rights, which means I think this was a craven political ruling written by a Democrat judge who wasn't about to jeopardize his reelection in a few months. So he gratuitously tosses Willis this lifeline to keep the case against Trump going, because if she's disqualified by the court, so is in her entire office. That's Georgia law. And that would effectively kill the charges against Trump, because any sensible prosecutor, I think elsewhere, would take one look at this case, recognize that it's weak or non-existent on racketeering. And in fact, I wrote a column 2 months ago that this case is such a legal, ethical train wreck, the state attorney general should take it over for review, and I think that may be where it's headed.
Yeah, that's so interesting. I'm looking at her and all her dramatic moments. I'm not going to lie, it's very entertaining, and I can see why he doesn't want to upset black female voters, many of whom like the way she is performing on the stand. But I guess the question I have is just where does this go in terms of the general public opinion about, you know, this being election interference, the entire process for Donald Trump, that they're trying to, you know, tie him up in these court cases. And I think it's kind of helping him make that case.
Yeah, it's classic lawfare.
Yes.
Weaponizing the law for political purposes. And, you know, Willis seems to be popping champagne corks. Well, I think that's premature. This ruling further delays the prosecution. It may put it in jeopardy, and she may not survive professionally, because a Georgia Senate investigation and a prosecutor's commission, now armed with the judge's findings, a scathing rebuke of Willis's behavior. I mean, he called her unprofessional, said she may have been untruthful and dishonest. My goodness, that is a breach of duty. It's grounds for removal from office, not just a case. She undermined the public's trust. But Willis is also facing additional probes, misuse of public funds, other improprieties. Reportedly, employees are lining up to testify against her. Yeah, so I'll make this prediction. I think she'll try to defuse all of this by announcing sometime soon that, oh, well, another prosecutor in the office will try the case. Well, that doesn't remove either her or the taint of a partisan DA who, as I say, weaponized the law to bring a politically driven case to influence a presidential election.
Her moment in the spotlight, and it seems to all be caving in, and the case with it, potentially, and all the cases, Gregg, it feels like across the board, the courtroom's getting farther away, even though they keep trying to bring it at Trump. Gregg, thanks for your time. Right. Appreciate it.
I'm Steve Doocy.
I'm Brian Kilmeade.
And I'm Ainsley Earhart. And click here to subscribe to the Fox News YouTube page to catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis.